Do I start talking now? I'm just gonna go, okay? Hello? It's been about, 3 years since Neppy came to my dimension, I think. Noire made her own nation and is working so hard to make it super cool. But because of her, Louis' shares have gone splat, and the two nations aren't friends. Oh, Planeptune is the same as ever. That's, my last cue card. Hey, so, did I do good, Neppy? You're not narrator material. Nope, nope. Oh, I was so confident. And with that, let's play on. Welcome back, by the way. Within Louise Basilicum.
Pardon me, Lady Blonde. I have compiled my report.
Oh, good work.
If I could give it a quick summary, it would seem last station is in a state of exponential growth. It would be accurate to call it a true explosion of activity.
That much, huh?
Indeed. Those outside of Louis who showed no interest in CPUs or games are migrating there. Which would not be an issue were that the only outcome. But...
It's fine. Just say it.
Yes. Well, a not insignificant number of Louisians have chosen to move to Last Station as well. It may have been rash for us to approve free immigration into and out of our nation.
Whatever. People had been whining about only being able to play our games while living here.
Until recently, Louis was the only CPU-led nation on this continent. Only we could give them peace of mind. Since we are no longer alone, the people seek a new paradise. Faith is such a fickle concept. Do you not intend to take action, Lady Blonde? I wish you would show some sign of concern. Oh, should this trend continue, we will lose Louis' long-standing superior position for good.
Minister.
Yes, Lady Blonde. No matter your command, I shall obey without question.
Shut up. You talk too much.
Indeed.
My pardons. But if you just review the report I compiled, you will understand my worries. With that said, excuse me.
Not like I'm sitting around doing nothing. Not like I don't plan to do something about it.
Meanwhile, at Planeptune's Basilicum. It's a bright, sunshiny day. It's even awesome indoors. When it's this warm, I feel like taking a nap. That's normal for you, Plutia. Don't be silly. You're sleepy no matter the weather, silly pants. Nuh-uh. I can tell you're sleepy too. I can't help it. The weather's so perfect for log sawing. Alright. I agree. Let's take a really long nap. Instant sleep coma. Why in game industry are you two sleeping right now? Heck, my wake-up alarm? That was so cool, Histy. Don't yell around napping people. I'm going to yell because this nation has two CPUs who do nothing but slack off every day. You simply must begin to tackle your workloads. I know, but look outside. The weather's too nice to do stuff. Napping is the best choice. Instant sleep coma. Again. Do not fall asleep in the middle of my lecture. The two of you ought to go learn from Noire. Noire? I guess we haven't seen her for a while. She's too busy. She became a CPU and made her own nation, you know, what's it called? Blast? Something? Sounded like lactation. Oh, Last Rebellion. The station. Oh, yep, yeah, that's the ticket. Noire's such a workaholic, huh? She can't make any friends because she loves working too much. Oh, is that why? It must be lonely to not have any friends. Her work ethic is what makes her a grand CPU. You two really should learn from her example. Ah, don't be a pissy mini histy. You'll get wrinkles on that teeny tiny cutesy wootsy face. That's right, Histy. You're so cute. Flattery will get you nowhere. PlayStation has enough shares to be a threat to Louis. Even though Planetune is home to two CPUs, we... Why do you keep praising Noire? There's nothing we can do about it. My Histy told me to sit tight until she thinks of a way to get me home. Well, that is true, but waiting patiently and doing nothing are... at all are different. She hasn't given us a ring-a-ling for years. If we try to call her, it won't connect. Well, connecting to a different dimension is a bit more difficult than a long-distance call. Even at maximum processing output, it takes me approximately 3 days to establish a connection. What do you want me to do about it? Mini Histy and my Histy are to blame. It's a double Histy fail. Maybe partially my fault, but that does not mean you may nap each and every day. Oh boy, if only Mini Histy could get in touch with my Histy, maybe then I could work hard. Oh well. Uh-oh, Neppy. She's vibrating with rage. It's just so annoying that Mini Histy is a junky old model that sucks so hard at computing things. In my world, Mini Histy would be less awesome than a calculator. Junksty. Snap. Oh, what a scary noise. You know, the usual. Who are you calling Junksty? I dare you to say it again. Deep-fried HDMI cables. Histy has evolved into Pisty. That was so mean. Histy has a complex about her low processing power. Really? Did I accidentally grind her teeny tiny gears? You are merely passing the blame onto me so that you can slack off, are you not? And Plutia, you are slacking off without offering any kind of excuse. Whoa, she's really mad. Don't pop your top, Pisty. That made me imagine her head flying off like a rocket. Ain't no time for goofy jokes, bud. You will not receive any lax treatment from me today. Go and learn from Noire. Get to last station this instant and see what it means to do the work of a CPU. Man, Noire's our teacher now. That makes my stomach feel weird. I got my pride, you know. Oh, yay, Noire! That's more like it. It'll be fun to see her again. But her nation is so far away, and I'm so sleepy. You are still saying such lazy things? Oh, that's one angry emote. Characters designed to be cute shouldn't make that scary face. Yeah, I want to see you happy. Give us a big smile. My facial expressions are not your concern right now. Get over to last station. Now! Oh. Owie! I fell on my bum. Can't believe she tossed us both out here. She's like a tuxedo-clad bouncer when she's mad. I've never seen Histy get that mad before. Neppy, you're a genius at pushing her buttons. Really? I mean, when you put it that way, I feel better about it. But isn't this kind of your fault too, Plutipoo? Huh? I don't get what you mean. Whatever. What do you want to do? We got kicked out and Pisty won't want us back for a while. I want to take another nap. Wait, I know. Let's go see Noire and ask her to let us nap. Oh, nice thinking. What a way to reverse our punishment into naps, I guess. Noire will be happy with us too. It'll be a nap party. Sounds better and better. With that settled, let's start moving towards the last station. For great naps! For great naps. Yay. What have we got? Jet Set Range! Right, let's look at the chirpers though. Skanganep! Boing! Jump! I'm a kangaroo! And of course, Fortify enemies? Probably won't turn that on. Just make things harder, won't it? Anyway, let's have a look at what's happening in Planetune. Oh, we've got Nepstation! Yo, we meet again, peeps. This is the Nepstation's best host, Neptune, and its best co-host, Plutia. What are we doing this time? My syllabus or whatever claims we're doing the news. We'll report on all things that might have happened lately in game industry, silly and otherwise. Oh, wait, if it's about things that might have happened, can we still call it news? Don't sweat it, my red-headed friend. We can just tack on a disclaimer that says, like, the contents of this program are fictional. Is that okay to do? It's cool, really. Here, read this first bit of news. Okie dokie. Two CPUs were born in one go. Ooh. Wow, that's some old news. Research properly, journalists. The other day, in Zeka 1 Ruins, two awesome girls named Neptune and Noire. Oh my, what amazing news! Apparently, these two lovely ladies became CPUs at the same time! When asked for their comments, they said, I'm the main character, so duh, and it wasn't tough to do or anything. Those comments do a great job of showing their confidence. Great job, Neppy. Thanks. After that happened, Neptune began to live in the gorgeous Planeptune Basilica. And Noire founded a new nation, Last Station. We're looking forward to see what they'll accomplish. There we go. We love looking forward. Okay, next topic. A murder in Planeptune Central Park. By a hang glider, from the looks of it. This report says that it happened kinda near Planetune's capital city. The culprit is said to have fled the scene with... is this right? With a hand glider? A smoking detective is on the case. And those in the area, be careful. Be careful. That wraps up the news. You know, Plutie, I get the feeling that I was the only one saying long lines today. You're imagining things. Am I? Well, okay. We'll keep presenting the news in this fashion from now on, so flip that TV on every now and then. Bye-bye. Watches again. Well, we will do. Pretty much straight away. Just Nep this time. Greetings, couch potatoes! It's finally here, the fun, happy mail order shopping program, Wallet Crusher Nep. Each installment, a lovely guest and myself will introduce products we recommend at bargain bin prices. With our exhilarating lineup, you'll be on the road to bankruptcy in no time flat. And now, without further ado, here comes our first guest, Planeptune CPU, Ludie. Whoa, she just popped in. She didn't glide in or pop up from the bottom. She just, boom, there. Let's have fun shopping. Since she's settled in now, let's roll out our first product. Blood Owl. Sealed up, use this. 24-hour to... Alright, fine. Reflex! Is this medicine that removes skill seal, right? You got it. We received some fan mail asking about the skill seal affliction, and now we're going to read it. It's from someone who listed a Nep name, so we'll call him Anonymous from Leanbox. Are they from Leanbox? Leanbox doesn't exist yet. Anyway, greetings, Neptune and Plutia. Greetings! Recently, I was talking with my good chum who, along with myself, experienced poison and paralysis. But we've never experienced any sort of skill seal affliction, so we are not sure what it feels like. Can you tell us? Is it like when I bend over and it hurts my back? Please tell us in great detail. Thus concludes the letter. Wow, so this person has been poisoned before, huh? That should be pretty uncommon for a normal person. Maybe he and his good chum chowed on funky mushrooms. Paralysis happens if you sit with your legs tucked under your bum for too long, so that ain't no thing. Okay, so, skills here, right? How do I put it? Feels fuzzy, like, maybe? To me, everything suddenly feels like a pain in the butt, and my body insists that it's crazy exhausted. I think that's what I meant. Oh, it's like feeling itchy, but not knowing where you need to scratch to feel better. Ooh, we're getting warmer. Even though you want to use the skill, you can't find him in your noggin. Did you get all that anonymous? That's it for this installment of Customer Care Corner. Wow, it's like we're on a radio show doing advertisements. Hehe, I've always wanted to try doing that sort of thing. Anyway, we're offering a pallet of reflex drinks at a steep discount. Oh, 10 reflex for 980 credits. If you think you need them, pry open that wallet and shove your money directly into the TV. Yeah, we'll go for it. Thanks for your patronage. Reflex received. Hi, back to Nep Station. Go on then. Millionep Quiz! Oh no. It's finally begun! Millionep Quiz, your host for today are the coolest girl ever, Neptune, and her coolest assistant ever, Plutia. So this is a quiz show? Yeah, thanks for pointing out stuff everyone already knows. We'll host a 3-question quiz each broadcast. The viewer will get rewards just for correct answers and stuff. Nothing happens if you're wrong. And whoever gets all the answers correct through the very last episode will get 1 million credits. You really will become a millionep. Whoa, 1 million? But wait, Neppy, what's up? The final episode is way at the end, right? Wouldn't it be easy to get 1 million credits by then? Let's start the quiz, go! Question the first of the following. What is my amazing kid sister's name? Well, it's Nepugia, obviously. Nepgear. All right, Nepgear. Dingly-doo. Healing grass received. Question 2. What item is required to become a CPU in this dimension? Well, a CPU fragment, of course. Yeah, I combine two together. Deal with it. Dingly-doo. Int booster. Question the third. What nickname did I, Neptune, give to her, Plutia? Well, obviously, Peru. Dingly-doo, Peru. Detoxin. Pencils down. Phew. Time sure flies, huh? We'll keep this exact pace for the other quiz installments. These kind of shows can be fun to host, too. That's it for now. We'll see you next time. There we go then. Oh, Nep Station just disappears from the menu completely. Just goes. Right, information. Neptune! Huh? Ooh, my ears are goopy. Are you okay? Are you cleaning your ears like a good girl? Actually, I don't think I have since arriving here. It's been years, because Nep Jr. was dedicated ear cleaner. It's been years, Nep! Ugh. That's no good. Only gross girls don't clean their ears. I know! I'll clean them for you right now! Huh? You do that? Yep. Come on, lay down on my lap with an ear facing me. Don't mind if I do! So this is Plutie's lap, huh? It's soft, but flexible and plush. I have my cotton swab ready. Here I come! Don't move! Okay, my body is ready. Tickle, tickle, scrape! Youch! Plutie, be gentle with my cochlea! Oops, I'm so sorry. Does it hurt here? Pick, scrape, grind! It hurts! You're scraping my brain! I'm sorry, your action is just so cute that I can't help myself. You can't help yourself, huh? Plutie, are you feeling sadistic right now by any chance? If you are, I'm at a huge disadvantage in this particular petition. particular position. Whoa, there's a whole lot of gunk inside your head. Hey, can I stick the cotton swab all the way into your ear? No, that is bad. You're only meant to do the outside, because you need the wax in your ear. It's very important. No, that's not necessary. I can clean my own ears from now on. Thank you very much. Already done? Boo. It's so boring. Dear, oh dear, she was lucky to get out of there alive. Or with ears. Neptune! So here I am, learning how to work from Noire. This must be a different place. Noire shouldn't care. Wait, you think it's normal? Come to the staff room later. Oh dear, Plutia! I'd never seen Histi so mad before. That's it? Alright, histoire! It's mini Histi! Oh, Plutia, doing no work and just napping. When you get back, I will not let you in the Basilicum. Oh dear. Let's get the other ones out of the way before we have a look at Marvy's. Let go! Huh? Is my work going well? It's fine. Thanks for worrying about it. Who are you? Dangly! Huh? Be careful not to get into an accident, you say? Do I look like the type that spaces out and gets hurt? Jeez, how rude. Grr and such. This manual. An item plan, huh? Basically, it's a way to get better items than what's available into shops. Oh, very well. Basilicum staff. Ah, hello. I work at Planetune's Basilicum. I don't appear in the story, but I do work here, you know. Well, this is the story from my point of view. Cameraman! Noire went away and I'm sad. She lets me take so many pictures of her. Oh dear, life fragment, beep. It looks like a nation called Last Station was founded. I wonder how that will change game industry. Indeed. Marvy! Hey, Marvy. Teach me ninja magic. As usual, Neppy, you say the strangest things out of the blue. But you're the first ninja. She says ninja really weird. Ninja we've had on our team. The first, I say. Plus, you have those beefy boobs. I fought with lots of folks, but this concept really amps me up. You can use shuriken and cast ninjutsu stuff, can't you? Of course. We learned such things in Ninja 101. But if that's all you've been... What? But if that's all you think being a ninja is about, you're sorely mistaken. Basic fighting and sword techniques are a given, but we use plenty of shadow implements as well. Shadow implants? No, not implants, implements. In other words, hidden weapons. Primary examples include blowguns and chains, sickles. Others exist, but they're trade secrets. We assassinate from the shadows, gather intel, and protect our lord, so we need lots of hidden stuff. So you can use Katon. Katon, alright. Katon? I don't know. And the fire's like, I burned your face. Or Suton, and the water's like, I washed it. Or like, is this an illusion? No, it isn't. This is death. Got anything like that? Your perception has been influenced by anime and manga, I see. But yes, I can use techniques like that. In my case, I use scrolls to call forth fire or wind to attack. Whoa, hey, so if I use a scroll, will crazy magic things happen? It does require learning the technique, but I think you can probably pull it off. Katon is a bit dangerous, so I'll let you try Futon. Wind, right? Thanks. So what do I do? Put the scroll between your lips and mutter an incantation while imagining the wind. The stronger the image in your mind, the stronger the technique. Okay, let's flip it to dry. Amazing, it was your first time, so you must have natural skills. Who else but a CPU, huh? Okay, Ma. Dear, oh dear. Neppy, stop! Enough! Holy macaroni! Marvy, stuff just got crazy for you. The wind is ripping your duds apart. Huh? But even though it's shredding her clothes to pieces, it isn't cutting her body at all. More importantly, stop the winds! Oh, I think I understand this. Yep, got it. Since ages past, when ninjas equip nothing, their defense stats go up. But to get an even higher defense, like that old film, they gotta have something dirty happen to him first. I'm not some blue ninja girl, stop the winds already! Alright, you're the type who ends up taking even more damage with the rip duds, huh? Sorry, Marvy. So, how do I stop the wind? You can't stop it! Nope. What? Someone stop the winds! Dear, it didn't take long for Marvy to lose parts of her clothes, did it? Right, so it looks like we're done there. Let's head off towards the last station.
Can I decide where to go?
No, you can't. Jet set range.
Going here, huh?
If we cross this, we'll be in last station country, right? I think. Then let's do it. To it. What an inconvenient word layout, though. You gotta trudge through a dungeon. Said word layout. World layout, though. You gotta trudge through a dungeon to get to another nation. You don't have to in your world? Nah, we retcon that system. Now you just click on a list and warp there with the X button. That's how it works here too. You just gotta clear the dungeon one time. Well, our civilization is so advanced that the roads are nicer and traveling is crazy simple. Sounds so nice. Maybe Noire could build a cute little road to Planeptune for me. Yeah, if she's working so hard, you'd think she could at least build a road. How thoughtless of her. How about the two of you implement your own idea and build it yourselves? Yeesh, I'm sorry. Me too. Wait, what? Huh? Did you just imagine what I just imagined? Hissy was lecturing me. Yeah, I heard it too. Maybe she's so busy that her rage-filled lectures can transcend space-time. Well, no use sitting here moaning about it. Let's hurry on ahead and do as we're told. You're right. Let's go see Noire. Teach me Hissy! Some monsters can go viral during battle. This will cause them to become far more vicious. Monsters that have gone viral are not to be underestimated. If a monster gets viral, others are more likely to get infected as well. The usual. Dangerous monsters. Dangerous species of monsters inhabit game industry. We, the Oracles, have classified them as dangerous, risky, and tough. These are listed in ascending order of difficulty. These monsters will not actively pursue you, so check your minimap to see which enemies are classified as dangerous. We'll skip them for now. Right, let's take one of every enemy, as we normally do. Good news in terms of the studio, though. I did find... Oh yeah, we've not got Noire now, have we? I did find... I need to get Red back in. That's what I need to do. I did find a place that gets me a big piece of wood that I wanted. Because what I've decided to do with that piece of wood is not tell you. Yeah, not telling you. Because, like I said previously, that sort of spoils what I've got planned. And I don't... Why is Plutia not in the group? That feels weird. But there. Red there. Nope. There we go, that's what we want. Sorted nice and simply. Alright, so. Let's get the flower. But I do need some LED strips as well. That's related to the whole get a piece of wood and a stencil of the N logo for Neptune. Hopefully the plan will work out with what I got planned. Obviously. It might not, and you may never know what I was planning. I'll probably tell you. If it doesn't work out, I'll tell you what it is, don't worry. But it will be, like I said, like 9 months away before it even becomes a thing. It'll be good if it works, though. It'll be good if it works. I'm talking about something that you have no idea, so it'd be like, well, I don't know if it's gonna be good, do I? Oh, damn it. Let's get these things deaded. Woad! Right, there we go. Yeah, I do need lots of LED strips. Does anybody know where I can buy some good LED strips? Because at the moment it's just, well, I'll buy some from IKEA. I need some that can change colour. No. Do I need some that change colour, or do I need white ones? That's the question. I'll probably just go with white LEDs, to be honest.
Faster now, Mew!
We need to take out one of the flower people thingies.
Found
you?
An item.
Indeed you did. Get the painting! Gotcha.
Active attack success!
Oh, nip your face!
Indeed it was a success.
Here you go! Hey! Bye-bye!
It's my turn!
I forgot to sort the commands for the EX finishes, haven't I?
Easy peasy! I'm gonna be
in! I'll do that in between the parts, because we only need to make it through this dungeon once, like I mentioned, and then we're done.
Kanganep!
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 Where do I Kanganep? Oh, I see. There we go. Gotta look for the shadow on the floor. That's what I gotta do. I've done a card bird.
Found an item.
I've done one of those spherical ones. So proceed onwards. There's a big dragon, which we're avoiding. Because they can be quite dangerous. Alright, what we got here?
Ooh, looks neat.
It's alright. Any boxes around? I don't see any shadows on the ground. I do much prefer this system of secret items. Yeah, I need to see the shadow here. Where's the shadow? Is it there? Yeah.
Boing, boing.
Because there's hints as to where they are, rather than the pressing square to send out a sort of like a radar type system where it's like boom, boom. Because that's just annoying, because you have to search everywhere. This, it's like, oh, I see it over there. I'm going to go and get that. Have we done a birdie? I don't think we did a birdie, did we? So we'll take out a birdie.
They're spaced out!
Oh, we've done a mushroom as well now. There we
yeah,
go.
Eat this!
Yeah. Why can't it always be my turn?
Just well, if it was always your turn, Nep, we'd win easily. So that might
there.
Be why.
Take this. Be gone. Be gone.
Did we miss?
This
I think we missed.
Fate.
Wait a little bit more.
Fancy rain.
My special.
Indeed. There we go.
Level up!
Right, so what else is around here? Don't see any mystery boxes.
Kanganep!
Kanganep indeed.
Jump. Boing!
Boing!
Found an item.
I just noticed we're actually back on Nep. I did make Plutia the Lydia. Lydia? The Lydia. Yeah, I made Plutia the Lydia. Don't know why I'm pressing that. Don't know what I'm doing. Don't know what I'm doing. Don't know what I'm saying. You know, the usual stuff.
Found an item.
What else is around? Oh, I think we're done for enemies. I'm trying to keep an eye out for boxes. I feel like there should be one around here. There's the secret treasure boxes. Hello? There's a secret treasure box.
Kanganep,
that's actually... That's the wrong menu. That's a habit from Final Fantasy XV that I've got now. Be red for once. That's a weird noise.
Jump!
Jump!
Boingy!
Boingy? Ooh, I don't think I've ever been red before. Running around and jumping.
Found something cool!
Did you?
Jump! Boingy!
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 Jump!
That red has just become slightly more better in my eyes because of the boingy. It's so cute. It's so cute. Alright, we'll have
treasure.
That.
Treasure!
Treasure! Right, so, let's proceed on to this event, I guess. Or should I save? I'll save, it'll probably be better. There we go! Hehe, this is kind of fun. This... We're just trying through dungeons and stuff. And it's been so long since the two of us went dungeoning together. Yeah, I changed the words. Deal with it. Yeah. Yeah, true. We've just been rolling around on the Basilicom's floor every day. Even I'm starting to see how it makes us out to be super worthless leaders. But I lose if I let it get to me. So, yep, it's fun to go out too. Says the girl as she yawns? Yeah. Yawns like a beast. Maybe I still like naps best. I'll agree with that one. Let's hurry and get to Noire's place so we can grab 40,000 winks. Okay. Roar. Huh? Uh-oh. Oh, that's a big one. Is that the boss for this dungeon? It's so in our way. Seems to be. Yep. Don't you dare stand between me and my naps. Oh boy, here we go. Plutia's brow is furrowing. A quick explanation. Plutia is a nice and sweet girl, but becomes a volatile grumpus when sleeping. I just want to hurry up and get to Noire's house. Oh no. Sadly, I haven't the time to play with you. I have no choice but to come down on you real hard from the start. Huh? Monster's feeling insecure. As expected from Sadie. Wait, this isn't the time to admire her skills. In order for me to keep up with her, I gotta transform too. Noire was quite clear when she told me not to let you transform, but... Don't ask, don't tell. Or maybe you want to squeal and get punished. I had no idea that you were such a masochist. If you transform when Noire isn't around, I end up suffering all the fallout. Don't say that. The little Neppy loves to go along with whatever I say. Perhaps I get carried away in that form, and may seem to be a little slow in the head. But that doesn't matter now. We must take care of this beast and return to our normal forms. Okay, your face is beet red. So cute. I love it. Dung-gun-dung.
I'll keep you around till I'm satisfied.
Right, let's get you deaded.
I've got you.
We'll get the rapid rushes going.
Yeah, jumping arc.
It's my turn.
Indeed it is.
Operation Revelation will now commence.
Let's see what happens if we do a shiver beam on it, though.
Vanish.
I want some big numbers here. Get it dead as quickly as possible.
Finally.
Fighting Viper.
You seem to be worth tormenting.
Hold on. There's still more I want to give.
Not bad.
That doesn't hurt.
Right, so Swift Strike. I don't think I've got any XC skills at the moment, have I? Red usually gets one early on. So I'll have a look and see if Red's got any XE skills when I get back around to her.
Operation Revelation will now commence.
Nothing there, so we'll go with a Conflagration Dust.
Burn in the mad fire.
Finally.
No XE skills there. Fighting Viper
you
once again.
Be worth torn.
Hold on. There's still more I want to do.
Impudent.
Turn.
Impudent indeed. No XE skill there. Cross combination.
Combo.
Probably kill it. We'll get to see if Red's got an XE skill. Probably hasn't.
It is my turn.
Oh no. Well, we're still not going to, apparently. Fine. Conflagration Dust.
Full
Let's
power.
Finish this thing off.
Sleep in your unfulfilled dreams.
Yeah, what she said.
I've grown.
Level.
This is what I feel.
Yeah.
Level up.
Looks like my
level.
I'm gonna get level.
No XE skills there, is there? None. Let me finish prematurely. I'm far from satisfied, but still. Yawn. I guess that's it from me today. Phew. You returned to your quiet self without much fuss. Well. I'm way too sleepy for HDD. Oh, my eyelids weigh a ton. You mustn't fall asleep here. Persevere until we reach last station. Fine, then give me a piggyback ride. Harden? Neppy? Piggyback? No, I am deactivating HDD, which will make it physically impossible for me to carry you. Piggyback! I don't want to walk anymore. Fine, climb aboard. Yippee! Neppy, you have such a large womanly back. Goodness, not even my own little sister has gotten spoiled like this. But there we go, we can proceed onwards now.
Boingy!
Boingy! Oh, my heavens, dear me! What's your problem? Don't use such a creepy voice, Chew! As usual, your mouth is as foul as your stench. I find my voice to be cool, with a husky tone. So, what's going on? The monster I had placed on the border between last station and Planeptune was just defeated. What? Who could do that? A CPU, evidently. But we don't know which nation's CPU is the culprit. This is bad, right? It's not good at all. We said it would be bad for the nations to communicate freely, so we put that monster there, but... we were foolish enough to believe a monster of that caliber would give a CPU pause, I see. Kinda funny to get mocked by the old hag who had her moldy, wrinkly behind handed to her, too. Tch, I only lost because they ganged up on me. It's pathetic how much of a sore loser you are. You're one to talk, you were turned into a whip by just the one. You are both worthless slobs. You weaklings bring shame to the seven sages. What did you say? Shut up, you little girls. If you're going to fight, go and do it outside. In any event, let's not get too worked up over this. We knew those three CPUs were friends beforehand. This was just a matter of time. Although, why it took this long is a mystery to me. Naps. I'm sure it's because those dumb kids were being lazy and napping and slacking off and stuff. Whenever I went to spy on them, I caught them snoring. Can you believe that? Well, I can't believe that CPUs would just slack off and nap for years on end. Well, they did. Let's change the subject, shall we? We ought to have someone look into this border crossing matter. More importantly, we must address the issue of last station's growth. I had thought I was supervising it appropriately, but its unprecedented growth was completely unexpected. I was against waiting. Ah, if only we had crushed it to dust first, we wouldn't be worried now. I agree, I loathe taking this much time to do anything. If the old hag didn't lose back then, last station CPU wouldn't even exist now, Chew. No right to talk about that incident, rat. Anyway, the weakening of Louis is progressing as planned, so there's at least that. Indeed, Louis' CPU has finally started to panic. Is that so? Maybe I'll go give that little girl one last push. I haven't seen her in a while. However, we proceed. I recommend we strike down last station at once. Honestly, kind of crushing on that raven-haired CPU. I love tormenting that type. Hey! You won't get a head start on me. I haven't gotten to go on a rampage in ages! Jax, teasing and rampaging against little girls. Last station CPU isn't little, so that's okay. Now, don't get so worked up. We'll discuss that along with our strategy later on in the meeting. Our talks are getting nowhere because our chairwoman is a flustered, hesitant mess. At least perform your duties as chairwoman properly. Just hearing you talk is starting to annoy me, Chew. I'm so very sorry. They're terrible bad guys, aren't they? They're just terrible. Right, we're finally here at the last station. Let me do stuff. Alright, there we go. Right, so we're done for now, and in the next part, we'll head off to the last station. So we'll see you then.
Where are we going?
Last station, next part.
I'd rather play games, but oh well.
Dear, oh dear.